everybody to rise. Mr. Angelo, can you lead the prayer? Good morning, class! So, how are you today? Okay, very good. But before we will start our discussion, I want to introduce myself. I am your teacher, Eliza, and I am your permanent teacher in your English subject. But before we will start our discussion, I want you to ask one thing. Now, what will you do if the teacher is talking here in front? Yes? Angelo? Okay? Keep quiet. Very good. Another one. Yes! Participate. Okay. Can I expect that from you, class? Okay, very good. Last meeting, we have discussed about coordinating conjunction. Now, from the class, who can give me or who can share me an idea about coordinating conjunction? Yes, May? What's coordinating conjunction? Yes, you are correct. Now, can you give me a sentence using coordinating conjunction? Okay, very good. How about Mark? Can you give me a sentence which uses coordinating conjunction? Yes, excellent. I am pleased that you have really understood our discussion last meeting. For today's lesson, class, you are expected to choose appropriate reaction to different situations given. Identify the modal verbs used in a song presented. Understand the use and meaning of modal verbs in sentences. Realize the importance of becoming a positive problem solver and perform a role play, talk show, and jingle integrating modal verbs under scripts or dialogues. This time, class, we will have a new lesson since we are done with coordinating conjunction. But before that, we will have first an activity called React on Me. I will present here different pictures with different scenarios. And all you have to do is to choose an appropriate smiley in response to the pictures that I will be presenting here. After that, you will imitate the picture or the smiley that you have chosen. Am I understood? Okay. Very good, class. Based on your activity, what can you say about it? Okay. Yes, May? Okay, that's awesome. But class, we should always remember that in every situation, we have to remain positive, even if that situation we are facing is good or bad. In connection to our activity, I will play a lyric video with a smile by Eraserheads. All you need to do is to sing along, and also, you need to understand the lyrics of the song. Am I understood, class?
Lift your head, baby, don't be scared of the things that could go wrong along the way. You'll get by with a smile. You can't win at everything, but you can try, baby. You don't have to worry, 'cause there ain't no need to hurry. No one ever said that there's an easy way. When they're closing all their doors, they don't want you anymore. It sounds funny, but I say it anyway. Girl, I'll stay through the bad times.
Korea. Yes, it is correct. The song is all about a person who tries to comfort someone. Now, how the persona of the song comforted someone? Yes, RJ? Yes, very good. There are many lines of the song that depicts the importance of positivity. Very well, class. Class, I have here lines from the song. Kindly read number one. Number two. Okay, class, what have you observed from the lines? Yes, Jay. Okay, the sentences indicates modality. To what specific parts of speech do you think these words belong? Maria. Yes, you are right, Maria. It belongs to verbs, specifically to modal verbs. This afternoon, class, I will discuss to you the modal verbs of prohibition, obligation, and permission. Are you ready and excited for our new lesson, class?
Modal verbs are a small class of auxiliary verbs used mostly to express modality, that is, likelihood, ability, permission, request, capacity, suggestions, order, obligation, or advice. Modals of prohibition. Modal verbs are used for prohibition. These situations are the opposite of giving permission. This modal verb for prohibition lesson shows you how to use may and can to prohibit someone or create rules.
Now, I have here examples of modals of prohibition. Now, from the class, you can give me an example of a sentence with modals of prohibition. Yes, Jane? Yes, that's correct.
Let us now proceed to modals of obligation. There are two types of modal verbs of obligation. Those that primarily express a firm obligation or necessity, must and have to. Those that express a recommendation or moral obligation, should and ought to.
Now take a look at the examples of modals of obligation. Okay, now Angeli, can you give me an example of a sentence with modals of obligation? Yes, that's correct.
And lastly, we have modals of permission.
These verbs are used to politely ask for permission, to make a request, and to offer a help to someone.
For further understanding of modals of permission, I have here examples, class. Okay, April, can you give me an example of a sentence with modal of permission? Yes, very good. Do you have any questions, class? Do you have any questions? Yes, very good. Okay, now class, we will go back to the song with a smile. From the class, who wants to share their ideas on how important it is to deal with our problems positively? Yes, Angelo? Very well said, Angelo. Being positive amidst a problem is seeing the bright side of it. We must always remember that being positive will lead a person to become productive. Am I right? This time, class, you will be divided into three groups, and each group will be given a task to be performed. Remember, class, that you will only be given 10 minutes to prepare your presentation. Are you ready?
The group 1 will be named the locally stranded individuals. You will perform a 2-minute role play on the importance of dealing with problems positively. In your script, integrate the use of modal verbs in your dialogue. The group 2, on the other hand, will be called the frontliners. Perform a 2-minute talk show focusing on the ways on how to be a positive problem solver. In your script, integrate the use of modal verbs in your dialogue.
And lastly, the group 3, who are the medical workers. Perform a 2-minute jingle focusing on the ways on how to be a positive problem solver. In your script, integrate the use of modal verbs in your dialogue. Please be guided with these criteria. Content 50%, creativity 25%, mastery 20%, audience impact 5% with a total of 100%.
That was very inspiring, Team Locally Stranded Individuals. Let's give them a clap, class. Okay, so the group 1 had presented a very inspiring role play. It is because they were like presenting a real scenario in front of us. They have showed and explained the challenges and sacrifices of our OFWs abroad. We must always remember that we must not neglect the sacrifices of our OFW, especially to those who have OFW in their family. Because class, it is very hard to leave your own home and live far away alone just to support your family. Now let's welcome the presentation of the Team Frontliners. That was a great performance, Group 2. Let's give them a farmer's clap. Now let's give a hand for Group 3, the Team Medical Workers. Congratulations, Group 3. You are tasked to make a jingle of the experiences of OFW and you did it well. Now this time, class, to test if you really understood our discussion, you will be answering 10-item quiz. In your phone and with your data connection, go to quizzes.com and enter this code. You may also use this link that will direct you to the test. Now, you may start.
In your assignment, to further assess your understanding about our lesson, you will write a 3-stanza poem. Each stanza consists of 4 lines on the importance of becoming a positive problem solver and having someone who can help you in dealing with such problem. Use modal verbs in your poem considering their use and meaning in sentences. Encode your output on a short band paper.
Is my instruction about your assignment clear, class? Okay, since everything is clear, let's call it a day. Goodbye, everyone.